Hello, my little gents. How are you? I think you all are safe and fine at your home. I, Nilofer Miss, welcomes to you all to the Mehdi English School. And which subject I am taking? Which lecture is this? This is the mathematics lecture. And for which class this lecture is? This lecture is for the class 2. So I hope that you all are ready to attend this lecture. So as you know this thing that before we start our lecture, we always see the quote first before we begin the lecture, right? So today also we are showing one quote. Let's see the quote of the day. So this one is the quote of the day. Dream big. Always dream big. If your dream is that you have to just get a second rank, don't dream for the second rank. Dream for the first rank. Dream big. Don't dream that you are getting a 80%. Don't dream that like. Dream that you will get a 98%, 99%. This is a big dream. So always dream big. Now we are in the chapter number 12. And the name of this chapter is a money. But before we start this lecture, let's see the quote. Not a quote, a revision first. Let's see the revision of the previous lecture, because we always start our lecture with the revision. Revision is a compulsory for you all. If you do more revision, your practice will be more improved. So let's do the revision here of the previous topic and then we'll move to the new topic. So now students, let's start the question number 3 of the textbook exercise. In the last lecture, in the previous lecture, we had done the question number 1 and 2 of the exercise 12A. Now, in this today's lecture, let's see a question number 3. So, here is the question number 3. There is a 2 sub-questions is given in the question number 3. Two sub-questions is given in the question number 3. So let's go with the question number A. Let's do question number A. So first of all, as I told you before also, that whenever you are solving something, whenever you are solving any types of question, just look for the instruction. If instruction is given or not, what you have to find? You have to find that if the instruction is given or not. Now see this, the instruction is given. Make rupees 4. What you have to make? Rupees 4. And we have to use these 2 coins. Rupees 1 coin we have to use and 2 rupees coin we have to use. Just these 2 coins we have to use only. Which coins we have to use to make rupees 4? To make rupees 4, we have to use these 2 coins only. See this. These coins is given also. A 1 rupee coin and a 2 rupees coins only. These 2 coins we have to use to make rupees 4. This example is already given for us. This one has been done for us. See, if there is a 2 coins is given and we have to make rupees 4. So which 2 coins we are using to make rupees 4? So to make rupees 4, we are using 2 coins of rupees 2. Which 2 coins we are using? We are using 2 coins of rupees 2. So 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. How much it is? 2 plus 2 is equal to 4.
Now, the one is done. Let's move to the number 2. See, here the 3 coins is given. Which coins is given? How much? 3 coins. But which coin we are just used to make rupees 4? We have to make rupees 4 only to use these 2 coins. You can use any much coins, but you have 3 coins and you have to make rupees 4. Which and how much coins you are using to make rupees 4? So first of all, let's use the coin of rupees 2. See, I am writing here number 2. See, I am writing rupees 2 coin. I am taking one coin of rupees 2. Which coin I am taking? I am taking one coin of rupees 2. So 2 rupees is done. So how much left now? More 2 rupees we have to add. So which coin I have to use? So it will be a 2 rupees, a 4 rupees. So let's use one coin of 1 rupee and more one coin of 1 rupee. So if you calculate these 3 coins, it is a 4 rupees. If you calculate together, it is a 4 rupees. Here is a 2 rupees, 10 plus one more coin, it means a 3 rupees, and one more coin, it means a 4 rupees. So total it is a 4 rupees. One coin we are using of rupees 2, and we are using 2 more coins of rupees 1. It means there is a 2 coins of rupees 1 and 1 coin of rupees 2. So total we are using 3 coins, 1 of rupees 2 and 2 of rupees 1. It is a 4 rupees now. Now here, if we have a 4 coins, what coins we are using? Which coins? So if we want to make a rupees 4 and we have a 4 coins, so we are using rupees 1 coin, another 1 rupee coin, one more 1 rupee coin, one more 1 rupee coin. See this. It is a 4 rupees. If you count it together, it is a 4 rupees. So how many coin we are using? We are using 4 coins and all the coins of rupees 1. How much coin it is? It is a 4 coins and all the coins are same of rupee 1. See this, 1 rupees plus 1 more, it means a 2 rupees, plus 1 more, it means a 2 rupees, and plus 1 more, it means a 4 rupees. So this one is complete. And whenever you are writing this exercise in the fair book, no need to draw this hand. You can draw a square box and just draw circle in it. I just repeat this thing again, that whenever you are writing this exercise in the fair book, just draw a one square and just draw a 2 circle inside it. For this, just draw a 1 square and draw a 3 circle inside it. And for this one, draw a 1 square and draw 4 circles inside it. And write down the coin name. It means it is a 1 rupees, 2 rupees, as I written here. These are 1 rupees here. We are using 3 coins as a 2 rupees and 1 rupees coin. This way you have to use it. You can write down it. Now let's move for the question number B. Make rupees 6. Which question we are taking now? See this, question number B. So always I say to you that whenever you start any question, just look for the instruction. What you have to look for? You have to look for the instruction only. So here also instruction is given, make rupees 6. How much money you have to make? Make rupees 6. and which coins we can use. We can use the coin of rupee 1, coin of rupees 2 and the coin of rupees 5. These coins only. We can use these 3 coins only to make rupees 6. One has been done for us. See, this one is already done for us. You can check this. If we have 2 coins, so which 2 coins we can use to make rupees 6? I repeat my sentence that if we have 2 coins, how many coins you have? If you have 2 coins, so which coins you are using? So if you have 2 coins and you have to make rupees 6, you can use these 2 coins. One coin of rupees 5 and one coin of rupees 1. These 2 coins you can use to make a rupees 6. One coin of rupee 5 and one coin of rupees 1. So it is a 6 rupees now. Now let's move for the next one. How many coins are given? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. We have 5 coins. How many coins we have? We have 5 coins. And we have to make a rupees 6. How much money we have to make? We have to make a 6 rupees. Okay. So which coins we can use to make rupees 6? I repeat my question that which coins we can use to make rupees 6? So I am giving you 10 seconds to thinking about it, that if you have 5 coins, so which coins you are using to make rupees 6? You have just a 10 seconds. Just think about it and just write down your own answer. Just push your mind for thinking. So first of all, we are using a 2 rupees coin. Which coins we are using? One coin we are using of rupees 2. First coin we are using of rupees 2. Then we are using a 1 coin of 1 rupee. We are using a 1 coin of rupees 2, 1 coin of rupee 1. So it is a 3 rupees now. How much money it is? It is a 3 rupees. One more coin we are using of rupees 1. One more coin we are using of rupees 1. So it will be a now 2, 3, 4. It is a 4 rupees now. Still 2 rupees left. How many rupees left now still? Still 2 rupees left. So let's take one more coin of 1 rupee. So it is a 2 rupees, 3 rupees, 4 rupees and 5 rupees. Still one more rupee is left. So let's take one more coin of 1 rupee. Let's take one more coin of 1 rupee. So maybe it is a 6 rupees now. Let's count it. If it is 6 rupees or not. So it is a 2 rupees, 3 rupees, 4 rupees, 5 rupees and at the last we are using one more coin of 1 rupees. So it is total a 6 rupees. Now we have 3 coins only. How much coin we have? We have just 3 coins. So how much money it is? Which coins we are using to make rupees 6? We have 3 coins only. So which coins we are using to make rupees 6? So let's take a 1 coin of 2 rupees. One more coin of rupees 2. One more coin of rupees 2 again. So it is a 6 rupees now. Check this, it is a 2 rupees. More 2 rupees, it is equal to 4. 2 plus 2 is equal to 4 and we are taking more 2 rupees. It is equal to 6 now. We are using 3 coins of rupees 2. How much coins we are using? We are using 3 coins of rupees 2. We are using. Now we have 4 coins. How much coins we have? We have 4 coins. So which coins we are using to make 6 rupees? We have 4 coins. So which coins we are using to make rupees 4? Let's take a 2 rupees coin. 1 coin we are taking of rupees 2. We are taking 1 more coin of rupees 2. Which coins we are taking? 1 more coin of rupees 2. So it is a 4 rupees now. 2 plus 2 is equal to rupees 4. Then it is a 5 rupees and it is a 6 rupees. So if we have a 4 coins and we have to make rupees 6. So let's use 2 coins of rupees 2 and 2 coins of rupees 1. This much coin we are using to make rupees 6. 2 coins we are using of rupees 2 and 1 coin we are using of rupees 1. So it is a 6 rupees now. Now the last one, that is a 6 coins, is given. So which coin we are using? So if there is a 6 coins and we have to make rupees 6. So we can use a 1 rupees coin. 6 coins we are using of rupees 1. We are just taking 6 coins of rupees 1. So here I am taking 1 coin of rupees 1. It is a 2 rupees, a 3 rupees. Here it is a 4 rupees, 5 rupees, and here it is a 6 rupees. So here we are taking 6 coins of rupee 1. So it is. So students, here is the worksheet. So as I told you before also, that whenever you are looking for the worksheet, just read the instruction. So here is the instruction. You can see, fill in the blanks. So one idea is coming in our mind that we have to fill in the blanks. We have to fill the blanks, okay? This fill the boxes, okay? The boxes is given here. You can see this. Some boxes is given here. Fill the boxes. Now let's read the heading of particular column. You can call it, this one is a column. This one is also a column and here is a column. This lines which is in a standing position. Which position we are talking about? We are talking about in a standing position, okay? So this is the standing line. You can call it a column. So first column. So what is the heading for the first column? Price of the item. You can read it in the blue color line, the sky blue color line, and some heading is written here, that price of the item. Some items is given, 5 item is given and the price is also given here. You can see this, the items is given, the picture of the item is given and also the price of the item is also given. This one is the first column. You can call it the first column. Now here is amount paid. So how much money we gave to the shopkeeper? This amount is shows that how much money we gave to the shopkeeper. What it shows? This second column shows that how much money we paid. It means we gave to the shopkeeper. And the third column, what it shows? The third column, check this, what is the heading? Can you try to read it? That what it shows, what it says about the third column? change to be given. In the third column, we have to write down that if the price of the chips, I am just giving you example, that if the price of the chips is rupees 5 and we are giving a 10 rupees note to the shopkeeper. The price of the chips is rupees 5 and you have a 10 rupees note into your hand. You having 10 rupees note and you are giving to the shopkeeper this note. So how much money he gave back to you? How much money he gave back to you? If the price of the packet of chips is rupees 5, you are paying rupees 10 to the shopkeeper. How much you are paying? If you have a 10 rupees note, one note of rupees 10, and you are giving to the shopkeeper, he is taking 5 rupees. So how much money he just gave you get back? How much money you will get back? So the answer is come, we have to write down in this box. You can see this already, there is a rupees sign is given here. We have to just write down the amount only. What we have to write down? We have to write down the amount only. We have to just write down the amount. So let's start with this one row, which is in a sleeping line. We are talking about this sleeping line. This first row, the chips, you can read it, and the price of the chips is rupees 5. Here it is given, this one is a row, which is in a standing position, this one is a row. So first one is a rupees 5 and chips. I'll show you by zooming it. Here is the chips and it is the price of this chips packet is rupee is a 5 rupees and here is the packet of chips. And how much money you have? See, the 10 rupees note is given. The price of this chips packet is rupees 5 and you have a 10 rupees. So if you are paying 10 rupees to the shopkeeper, so how much money he get back to you? He gave you get back. How much money you get back from the shopkeeper? So if you are paying 10 rupees to the shopkeeper and the price of the chips is rupees 5, so you will get back rupees 5. How much money you have now after paying to the shopkeeper, after buying this chips? You have a rupees 5 only. How much money you have now? You have a rupees 5 only. Now the next row we are taking, which is a hat. Let's see this. This is the second row we are talking about. This one. This hat is given. Now see this. If you want to buy this hat, if you want to buy this hat, you can see this. And the price of this hat is rupees 15. What is the price of this hat? The price of this hat is rupees 15 here. And you have a 2 notes of 20 rupees. How much notes you have? You have 2 notes of rupees 20. It means 2 notes of rupees 10. It means you have a 20 rupees. You are paying, you are giving 2 notes of rupees 10 to the shopkeeper. How much money you are paying to the shopkeeper? You are paying 2 notes of rupees 10 to the shopkeeper. And the price of this hat is rupees 15, right? So how much money you will get back? If the price of the hat is rupees 15, you are paying 2 notes of rupees 10, it means a 20 rupees you are paying to the shopkeeper. So how much money you will get back? How much money you will get back? Rupees 15 you will get, rupees 15 you have to pay. So if you do a subtraction, if you cut 15 rupees from the 20, you will get back or rupees 5. How much money you will get back? You will get back rupees 5. Now let's see the next one. So here is the packet of cookies is given. What is the price of these cookies? This packet's price, the packet of the cookies, and the price of this cookies packet is rupees 10. What is the price of these cookies? It is a 10 rupees. You have to pay for this rupees 10. And how much you are paying to the shopkeeper? You are paying to the shopkeeper is rupees 20. How much you are paying to the shopkeeper? You are paying rupees 20 to the shopkeeper. And how much he will get back to you? How much money you will get back from the shopkeeper? If you are paying 20 rupees note, if you are paying a 20 rupees note to the shopkeeper and you have to pay rupees 10. So if you cut 10 rupees from the 20, how much money you will get back? So 20 minus, it means you have to cut the 10 rupees from the 20. How much you will get back? So you will get back rupees 10. How much you have now? You have just a 10 rupees now. How much money you have now? You have a 10 rupees after paying a 10 for this cookies packet. And if you have a 20 rupees note, you are giving to the shopkeeper to this 20 rupees note. So you will get back rupees 10. How much money you will get back from the shopkeeper? If you have a notebook and pen into your hand, so just do the subtraction. Just write down 20 upside and write down 10 in the under the 20 and just make a subtraction sign and do that. It is 10 answer is come or not. Now the next row we are taking is a cupcake. See, this cupcake is given here. The picture is cupcake is here. So yummy, right? So the price for the cupcake is rupees 8. What is the price of this cupcake? The price for the cupcake is rupees 8. What is the price for the cupcake? Is rupees 8. And how much you are paying to the shopkeeper? You are paying to the shopkeeper is rupees 8. So if you are giving 10 rupees note to the shopkeeper and he is taking 8 rupees from this 10 rupees note. So just take a 10 fingers. This money is, you can count by your fingers also. Just take a 10 fingers and just remove the 8 fingers from this 10 fingers. How much fingers are left? If you are just bend your 8 fingers, if you remove your 8 fingers, if you hide your 8 fingers, what to do? You have to hide your 8 fingers. You having 10 fingers, right? And you just hide 8 fingers from it. So how much money you have now? So you have 2 fingers still left. It means how much rupees you have now? You have still 2 rupees left. Still 2 rupees have you. Now the next we are taking, and also a last one, a packet of noodles. Which packet is given? The packet of noodles is given here. You can check this. Which packet it is? The packet of noodles is given. Check this, students. And what is the price of this noodles packet? The price for this packet of noodle is rupees 12. See this, here something is written. Rupees 12. So it is the price for this noodles packet. So it is a 12 rupees. And how much you are paying to the shopkeeper? How much money you are giving to the shopkeeper? One note of 10 rupees and one coin of 5 rupees. These two things you are giving to the shopkeeper. So how much money it is? It is a 15 rupees. One note of 10 rupees and one coin of 5 rupees. So it is a 15 rupees. How much money it is? It is a 15 rupees. Okay. So students, if you are paying 12 rupees from the 15, how much money you will get back? How much money shopkeeper will give you back? So the price of the noodles packet is rupees 12 and you are giving a 15 rupees to the shopkeeper. How much money he will get back to you, students? So he will get back to you a 3 rupees. How much money he gave back to you? He will give back to you a rupees 3. 3 rupees he will get back to you. So just make your own examples. This way you can take any types of things. Just give a price by yourself. Just put the notes by yourself and just do the subtraction. Just try to meet yourself that how you can do these types of sums. So this one is a homework for you, students. You have to take a 10 things. How many things you have to take? You have to take a 10 things and make these types of worksheet. No need to put up pictures. You can just write down the name of the spelling. This one is for the practice, not a compulsory, but if you want to make a more practice, you can do this way. You can make your own worksheets also. So do this way. Just make these three column here as in the given worksheet. You just make three columns: price of the item, amount to paid and change to be given. So these types of worksheet you just make and just change these things. What you have to change? Change the things and amount paid. You also make the changes in this and just do the practice. Now, thank you so much, students, for watching this video. Please write down all the worksheets and exercise in the fair book. It is compulsory for you all. And write down in the one time rough book also. And stay home, stay safe. Have a nice day. So, students, we'll meet in the next lecture. So still, bye-bye.